Well, hello everybody. Today on the bench we've got a Connex 3300 HP that a customer sent in and said his S meter wasn't working and also said he had intermittent transmit problems. So let's take a look. We've got the cases off already. We've got the radio here, and as we key it, let's see. Let's zoom in. Better turn it on. You can see the green light. As we key it, the light changes to red. Meter doesn't work at all, which he says it didn't. But let's go over here and look at let's look at the watt meter. See what kind of wattage we're getting. We're on the right band. We're on low power. So let's see what we've got. We're on frequency. Got a little frequency counter down there plugged in just to see. Let's come over here and get rid of that stupid. And we're on the 10 watt scale. And we're keyed up and we're getting, wow, not really moving the needle. But we are getting a little bit of a carrier. Let's flip it up on high power. See what happens. Oh, looky there. 10 watt dead key. Got carrier, 10 watt dead key. Could it just be something as simple as maybe our low power potentiometer is either dirty or went defective? Let's take a look. Hold on, we'll be right back. Okay guys, we're back. I want to show you something. Let me get my something I can point with. Here we go. Alright. I'm going to zoom in a little bit. As you can see, let me get my pointer in the right place. There we go. Alright, as you can see, this is our high power adjustment. These wires are right here in the way. I don't know if we can get them out of the way or not. But this is, that little wires are being a pain. Let's see. Now, right here is our low power adjustment. I want you to look. Let me zoom a little closer. Focus, come on. All right, there we go. All right, as you can see right there, I don't know if you can tell what's wrong, but you'll notice this pot is completely turned off. That's off. So let's turn that up just a little. Well, it wasn't completely turned off, but it was very low. Let's turn it up just a little bit. Let's see if we get any kind of a carrier. Let's go back to low power. Oh my. There we go. Yeah, look at that. We're up to almost a 1 watt. Just by turning the adjustment. It looks like we've got to do some other testing here. Let me get this crazy thing to zoom in or to focus. It looks like we've got misadjusted pots. We haven't checked anything on the finals. We haven't checked the bias or anything yet. Let me somebody spread the trap. Wow, the 54 megahertz trap is spread way out. Let me do some work and get this set up and do some initial checks, and we'll be back. We'll see if we can find something else going on here, or if it was nothing more than just simply that pot being misadjusted. We'll be right back. Hold on. All right, guys, we're back, and we found another problem. Not only transmit, but we have no modulation. As we key, let me take you over here to the scope. We've got a carrier. Hello, hello. We're keying. No modulation. Now, if I take and wiggle that right there, hello, hello. We got a problem in the wiring harness there. I've got it, adjusted that wire, or wiggled that wiring harness. Now we've got modulation. But right in that wiring harness right there, we've got a problem. So, tell you what, let's do. Let's do a little poking around in there and see what we can find, and we'll be back with what we found there. Be right back. Okay, I'll show you what we found. This camera will allow me to zoom in that good. Yeah, about to lose it. Come on, camera. I apologize, guys, on this camera work. It's terrible. I know it is. There we go. Alright, so I want you to look right here, guys. Look at this great solder work on these. Pretty bad, especially that one. So what we're going to do is we're going to take, you can see the cracks around, a couple of them there. We're going to take and desolder all that and re-clean it, and then re-solder that header and see what happens there. I think that'll help us a bunch. We'll be back in just a little bit. Give me just a minute to get that done. Okay, guys. Oh, let me shut that. I'll get that shut off where you can hear. All right, you can see now what we've done is we've cleaned all these off. You can, I'm getting the right spot here. You can look through there and see that each one of them's been cleaned. We've desoldered them, cleaned the pots, or cleaned the pots, cleaned the pads, and now we're going to go ahead and resolder those, and I think we'll have a good connection. Give me just a few minutes, we'll get this thing resoldered, and we'll be back. Okay, we're back, and yeah, let's see. As you can see, we've resoldered that entire header. Hopefully you can tell that it's good and shiny, got good pattern on it. That probably helps a little. We turn it that way so you can see. But that's got that taken care of. We also got our meter taken care of while we were there. We had to loosen the screw, which I did a video on that not very long ago. Loosened that screw, which in turn loosened up the meter and got it ready to go. It's, I don't know if you can see it wiggling, but it wiggles now. So our S meter is going to work. And so now what we got to do is verify that we've got the problem with the modulation taken care of, get our meter back installed, put our faceplate back on the front and all of our knobs, and then we'll be back and see what we got to go through next. Okay, guys, we're back. And as you can see, we've got the radio put back together, and we've got all of our problems taken care of, I believe. You can see here that if we key this thing up, 1, 2, 3, 4, you can see our S meter is moving there just fine. 1, 2, 3, 4. You can hear us coming through our monitor radio. As you look over here, let's see, I get that off that shadow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, L audio. And you can see that we've got good modulation again just by repairing that that run that we did and setting the dead keys properly, making sure the bias is set properly, repairing our S meter, making sure it's good. We also had to replace the S meter, the little cradle, that plastic cradle. It was had one side torn off of it. We replaced that, and oh, the band switch on the high-low band switch, we had to fix that. Somebody had pushed in on the and got it broken loose, and it wasn't making a good connection, so we repaired that. But this radio is done now, and is as you can tell, hopefully it's talking well. It receives good. We've got her all taken care of. So guys, I'm glad you followed along. If you did all the way through this video, I hope you enjoyed yourself and saw a little something that you picked up that you like. If you have any repair work you need done, be sure to give us a holler. If you need any radio equipment, make sure you check us out on the web at customcbradios.com. This is CB Repair Guy saying thanks again for watching. Like and subscribe if you would, it would be great. Have a great day, guys. Until the next video, we'll see you soon. Bye-bye.